Hi, I'm Rick.
Hi, I'm Oscar.
Oscar, you prepared something cool for today.
Yeah, I want to talk about Azure Front Door Service.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, I thought so. Azure Front Door Service, it's a global service.
Yep.
Global, pay attention. That manages and monitors the global routing for your web traffic.
Yeah, so if you have a global application and you want to have it do routing and stuff, then Front Door can help you.
Well, news for you, I'm running a global application for my daily project.
And you need some routing.
I need some routing. At the moment, I have a reverse proxy in place with some path routing. But I actually need something better.
Yeah.
And when I saw this, beginning of the year, and it got GA a couple of months later, I was really interested because it sounds like my scenario. So I looked into it.
Yeah.
And I want to tell you a bit about it. So it's routing for your app. So it's an endpoint. The thing is, Azure Front Door Service, if you deploy it or if you create a new service,
configure it,
it's not going to some region.
But everything's in a region in Azure.
Well, yes and no. It's actually the configuration being pushed to the POPs, the edges.
So that's even closer to our potential clients.
Yeah, we have the 64 POPs at the moment for Microsoft. And the rules are running there.
Wow.
So the moment you save something in it, you save some routes and some stuff I'm going to show you later, it gets popped to all those endpoints. So it also takes a few minutes to...
And that's probably the reason why. It needs to propagate
across
the globe.
The thing is, and that's why, because it's a really complex service, I can imagine, but got from preview to GA really fast, but this is actually used for a while now by Microsoft itself for some services.
They're dog-fooding a lot of stuff that they're putting in Azure.
Yeah. So, really cool. If you look in like high overview of this, it can do SSL offloading. Well, SSL is not SSL anymore these days, but it's TLS. But also, it can do offloading. So if you really want to be really high performant, you can go HTTP from front door servers to your backends.
Yeah.
Provide SSL to your or TLS to your users. But I would say I don't want unencrypted traffic anywhere, so nice feature,
but
not going to use it. It provides global load balancing, HTTP only layer 7 of the network stack, with instant failover. Instant failover means that, hey, this is not responding, I'll try one of your other backends.
But that being a key point, right? One of your other backends. Because if you have one,
you need one.
then it's fail, and then it's over.
That's also, maybe out of space. In the case you have only one, you don't have an alternative.
Yeah.
But in most cases, especially if you want to use that global presence, you probably have in multiple regions, multiple APIs running.
Yeah.
So it finds from your client the shortest path to your endpoint, and that's on your POP, so your closest POP.
Yeah.
For us here at the moment, it will be one of the regions probably, but from there it connects to your region. That's also closest. So that means you don't have to think about it too much. You have something running in West EU or you have something running in US.
Yeah.
A client from there will pick up the best route.
Cool.
So that's really cool. It gives you control in one central point. That's the main part of it. It's one service.
Yeah.
You can add all your incoming endpoints. Like, these are my domains. Or these are, you might have multiple for maybe different language sites or just multiple URLs. You want to provide route-based routing on or path-based routing on some services. Because I want to deploy only that API or that API.
Yeah.
I'm not making a monolith.
Of course.
Let's not. So it's really powerful in that case. I have some diagram here showing the user comes in with one request. It goes to one of the POPs.
Yep.
It will be routed there with some nice magic. And you can actually add some application security there. You can do a web application firewall.
Oh, cool.
You have WAF policies in Azure, and you can use them on this one.
Yep.
You can just apply it.
And I also see static content caching.
Yeah, there's static content caching, so and that will happen at the POPs itself.
So closest to our potential customers?
Yeah, a lot of images and stuff. You can just forget about it. It won't hit your backend servers anymore.
Cool.
And with backend servers, it could be a front end for you, but it's the backplane of the Azure Frontdoor server.
Yeah, that's as far as terms go. That for me, the first time was a bit distracting. They have front end and back end, but back end is actually your application.
That's
and front end is the endpoint that people connect to.
That's the front end of your Frontdoor. That's your. And it has DDoS protection there at that point. So you see there, this is the example as I just mentioned, you have two regions with whatever in it, some HTTP endpoints, either it's a VM or app service or whatever. There's a probe going for which one's healthy. So even though region two is closest, if you're deploying some apps there and you didn't use any of the nice staging slot or you just messed it up this time, it will fail over to the other one.
Cool.
So it's either closest or the one responding. So having two regions out there gives you already two benefits. If you split your app like that, if you do your deployment like that, is you have your failover because you have the second one, even though it's a bit longer route in some cases.
Yeah, but still.
And you have your performance. If everything works, you have the best connection.
Very cool. What does this look like in the portal?
Yeah, I can show you in the portal. I'll just have to go into the portal here. So you have in Azure, you just have you can create a resource. You select Frontdoor, set one up. Otherwise, we need to wait. This one is called BetaTags. It gives you a host, it gives you a URL, so betatarks.azurefd.net.
Azure
Frontdoor. And you have a Frontdoor designer in there. Your Frontdoor designer has those front-end hosts, so incoming.
Yeah.
It has your back-end pools. The stuff actually hosting some content for you.
Yeah.
And you have your rules. Well, of course, front-end hosts, it's a name, you can add a custom host name, you can even have Azure providing you with certificates.
Cool.
And renewing them fully automatically,
cool.
So hands off.
that's
really
nice.
Then you add your backend pools, there's one in there, but if you add you give it a name, you add a backend, you can just select, there's some convenience in here. You can do custom, you can just add a URL, but you can press app service and it will just list the app services you have in that subscription and you can just pick them.
Which is awesome.
And you see here the priority of a backend pool if it does the same thing and you can put some weight in the route. So default load balancing.
Yeah.
So puts everything on the same weight. You have round robin and we'll see, but if one drops, it drops. And then you actually define your routes. And what you actually always need is one route that does a catch-all.
Of course, because otherwise requests might go missing.
Or and you get a horrible error message. So
yeah, you don't want that.
No. So you can set up stuff. You can do actually redirection if you want, or you can do rewriting. So you can. There's a difference between that it throws.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you can enable the cache here. Like this route is cached.
Cool.
Also good to say there's a purge thing here that purges your cache.
And is it smart like Azure CDN that it knows which is static content and what is dynamic content?
Well, for the cache, I can show you. You can set some behavior. You can even say, well, ignore query strings and whatever, and then it becomes really static.
Yeah.
I don't know if you want that in most cases.
But still, it's cool that you have the option.
Yeah, and even the dynamic compression is added later on. So even if you're not hosting that, it will.
Cool.
So those are really cool features. If I go back to the overview, so it accelerates performance by doing a couple of tricks. It connects with the client and then it will connect with your backend and it does that in some smart way. There are some protocols used to make that as fast as possible
and of course because
without reconnecting and stuff.
And of course, because it's hosted in the POP, it's fast.
It's close.
Yeah, it's close.
And the Azure network internally is pretty fast.
Cool.
Also, if your backend, one of your backend pools is hosting HTTP or HTTP 2, it will just use that. So you will set up that connection. This endpoint actually is also provided over IPv6.
Cool. Cool.
Also nice, because internally in the data centers, that's not really a thing yet. Always. It can do a redirection, rewrite, what I told you. The security, wow. Oh yeah, and the session affinity, that's the thing. Because session affinity, of course, reminds me of, oh, you build a monolith, you idiot, so you need session affinity.
But sometimes you've got A-B testing, or and then you like your users to go back to the...
Yeah, you're putting out a canary company. Build or whatever. Yeah. You want them to stick with that feature, not having it next click, you don't have the feature.
Yeah.
So there are still some cases for having affinity. And of course, if you want to, some of us have some history in an application, so you need to carry it. So the affinity is there, like everything that's in there is, it's nice. It feels like a complete product. It's one backbone.
It's an enterprise product, right?
Yeah, it's really, it's big. It has some costs, of course, cost per rule if you add more. It has a data transfer cost. Yeah. So you have to calculate what is my current setup, what is it going to cost. But for my setup, it's like having the VM there, which I have now. It looks like it's about the same,
and
but
then this is
I have some
more
extra DDoS protection. It's configurable because I have a nice panel. Yeah. And it's also more ready for the future than my current solution, I think.
I'm not going to judge that one. So thanks, that's actually a pretty cool service.
And yeah, so if you come across to something that does some routing,
That's a global
and especially
presence.
If you have some global presence, then this is it. Then you should definitely check out. If you have some different scenarios, load balancer, application gateway, there are multiple things there.
Traffic manager.
There are a lot of things there. And this is one. This is the newest one in the family, I think.
Yes, it is.
But this matched my scenario best.
Cool.
Maybe yours not, but be aware that this stuff is there.
At least have a look. Thank you so much for now. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.
Bye.